Alright, well, what's going on YouTube? So today we're flying a 915 IS VL3 and we're going to be testing some cool new features that we have just installed. One is a togo button, so it's a go around button. Essentially what this is done is it will set a flight director on your Garmin G3X and you will essentially do like a missed approach pattern or route, you could call it. Unfortunately, we don't have any auto throttles in this plane, so we do have to just manage the throttle. The second feature we have here is Smart Glide, so it's something you can use if you have an engine failure. It will pretty much set you to, it will pitch the airplane to your best glide speed, and will it actually select a nearest airport or no?
Yeah, nearest airports, and it's going immediately to the best glide.
Okay, so immediately best glide and select the nearest airport. This is super, super cool. So I haven't tried it out yet, so I'm super excited to see how this works in reality. Do our quick lane test, fuel pump test, and we will be ready to go
shortly. You are.
Just got the message. Ready to go when we are.
30 seconds.
So you'll see it on this other camera up here. In this plane today, we have a GTN 650 hooked up to an autopilot controller, GMC 507, with the level button. Two Garmin G3Xs on the left and right side. Electric flaps, hydraulic propeller, rescue system, landing lights, strobe lights, cockpit light, heated pitot tube, all the bells and whistles.
Y'all ready?
Ready. Seatbelt check. Okay. Seatbelt is set. Parachute is out. Canopy is locked.
And Oscar Kilo Zulian from Golf 34 is lining up and taking off runway 12.
Boom. Big dip. Okay, let's go.
All the speeds today are at knots and altitude is
awesome.
Speed.
Very happy.
Set, airspeed is alive, temperature and pressure is all in the green. And we have a positive rate, gear up, flaps up.
There's a big, big difference from the 914 I flew yesterday. It actually put me in my seat now, I wasn't expecting it again. You think you get used to the plane and then you don't fly it for a while and it surprises you again.
Yeah, that's true. We will climb to 5,000 feet.
You want to do 5,000?
Yeah, for the smart glide function, because I will ask a clearance to part of it to the military guys.
Okay.
And the altitude, because we're limited otherwise to 2,500.
No worries.
Okay. Which is a monitor.
Part of its approach, Oscar Kilo Zulu Uniform Golf 04, top of the
dead. Oscar Kilo Zulu Uniform Golf 04, part of its radar health.
Good evening, we would like to have 5,000 feet over at Viso Comito for the next 10 minutes.
Oscar Kilo Zulu Uniform Golf 04, roger. Altitude 5,000 feet, up to altitude 5,000 feet over Viso Comito, QNH 1013.
Up to 5,000 is approved, on 1013. We give you a call when ready for descent.
It's a good day. I thought you said there was some bad weather rolling in.
Well, you see on the right, there is some light thunderstorms building up, but it's leaving us.
Yeah, it's not too bad today.
It was supposed to come over our area, but it's going more to the
northeast. North, yeah. I think,
and on the left you see another one, but this is also
it's fine.
We're fine.
Yeah, so we just got permission from Pardubic to approach. It's essentially we're here in a little military zone for that they use for training a lot, but it doesn't seem to be too busy today. Yesterday we saw some helicopters and some formation flying going on over our airfield, but today we're pretty clear. Look, so we're up in the air for less than 3 minutes. We're already passing through 2,700 feet, and that's not even climbing aggressively. We're just circling above the field.
We're doing an 800 feet a minute now. Yep.
I'm happy it's quite smooth right now. No turbulence, nothing.
Oh, it's fine. Okay, we will take a bit of more flight performance.
never tells me when he wants to pull up, he just...
That's more fun.
Yeah, so we're doing essentially a VX climb right now, which is about close to 2,000 feet a minute at 75 knots.
And don't forget, today it's 30 degrees outside.
Oh yeah, it's 30 degrees outside, two souls on board, and let me check how much fuel we have. We have a good amount of fuel. We have about 80 liters on board, just a little bit under 80 liters, so that is, quick calculation, 22 gallons, 20 gallons I think, something like that.
Oh.
This is crazy, crazy angle. Yeah, we have essentially what it's 16 degrees pitch up, nose pitch up was.
Okay, let's do the exercise. Idle, we have an engine failure. Engaging smart glide.
Smart glide active. Engaging autopilot. Airport 5 o'clock, 2 miles.
Oh, that's cool. I didn't know it does the whole audio thing.
Yeah.
And so, will it actually take into consideration the wind? Do we have any wind data right now?
Yeah, we have 60 knots tailwind.
Okay.
And here we can select the emergency squawk, of course.
Okay.
And the emergency frequency, 1215. And our nearest airport he chose was Visakhomito, our home base. He's explaining us which runway, what surface, length of the runway.
So which runway is it? I'm curious what runway it's going to choose right now.
He will bring us over at the field.
Oh, over at the field. Okay, so it won't actually line you up, just bring you over at the field. And then we have to take manual control over.
Yep.
Wow, that was really, really, really easy.
The good thing behind this system is if you're flying over a terrain you've never been before, if you have an engine failure, you just press the button. You don't have to think about which airport is the nearest. He just tells you this is the nearest airport.
It doesn't actually take into consideration terrain as well. Is it going to fly me into terrain?
Terrain
or no?
And also winds. Because yesterday when I tried the system again, I was with a lot of tailwinds to the nearest airport, like 10 miles ahead of this position here, and he brought me to this airport, this little one.
Okay, because you wouldn't make it back with the headwind.
Maybe, yes, but it was safer to go this way.
Okay.
And he's taking the safest option.
Yeah, yeah. And I don't know if you'll be able to see it on the GoPro, but we have this little ring here, I guess, which is showing us our glide at the moment. And holy shit, well, I shouldn't say that here, but it's really keeping that glide really, really well, much better than I could do. It's good. Yeah, no, but in an emergency, so we have a substantial altitude, and look at this, so we're dropping at best glide around 75 knots, and we're doing, what, 500 feet a minute?
Yep.
500 feet a minute best glide, so we were at 5,000 feet, and so what does that give us? Almost 3 minutes of, roughly 3 minutes of time to think. So engine failure in this terrain, in this weather, it's a non-event.
You have even time to drink a cup of coffee.
Yeah. We need to get the cup holders installed. We want to 3D print some cup holders to try out, and then we'll be real pilots with with cups of coffee.
We should work on that idea.
Yeah. Good stuff.
And now he's holding us over at the airport, making orbits.
Yeah, yeah.
And then he's just telling you the altitude above target.
Yeah,
so now he told us 3,000. Above this, at 4,000, we had the 3,000 warning.
Yeah, mind you, I did say we're dropping at 500 feet a minute, but we're at idle power. If our engine was completely out, I think it would increase a little bit.
This would be something we can try in the next time we do a video with the Air Master prop. We can tear down the engine and put it in a feather function, and then we can try the real glide ratio.
Oh, yeah,
because now it's 40.
Yeah.
On the VL3.
Mind you, on our regulations here, we are allowed to actually shut off the engine during these type of exercises under this category of airplane. It's funny, we're gonna descend longer than it took us to climb.
Yes. Yes. Okay, I will cancel the approach.
How are we looking?
And then we will start for the exercise.
Yeah. Are you on Thunder Bitsail?
Yeah,
switch over, I'll give you a couple
of. Go for it.
Looking good, we're just doing the smart glide function, so it's holding us over the airfield. I think we're gonna go do the Togo next. That's how we're
Okay. I will will say goodbye to Pardo Bitze and I will line up. The procedure starts from Little Bichel. I give you just position reports, 10 miles, 5 miles, 4 miles. Like this, you know when to line up with the drone. That's okay?
It's his first time with the radio.
2 minutes before ETA to Visokamito so that I can be ready, that's all.
Okay, we'll go. Oscar Kilo Zulia from Golf 04. It's now 2,500 feet. We would like to climb back to 3,000 and start a long final for the runway 30. Heading now to the east.
Oscar Kilo Zulia from Golf 04. Roger, climb out to 3,000 feet.
Smart glide cancelled.
Copy that. 1013, 3,000. So we'll give you a call and we send below 2,500.
From radar, thank you.
Okay, now we're gonna do a visual approach with the 650. It's a non-official one. If you have an official airport with an ILS or a GPS approach, you can do the official one. But here it's just a visual 3-degree path, but it's still possible with the approach function to shoot the whole approach and final on autopilot.
And it's just using the GPS to do it?
Yes, GPS connected with the G3X. And then in short final, we will go around and we get the vectors with the flight directors, which I just put full power, gear up, flaps up, and it's making the missed approach.
Okay. I'm curious. I'm really curious how that's going to do it work.
It's 3,000. We put in. Select an airport. Visokamito. Okay. Okay, here we select the visual.
Okay. Oh. Yeah, now we got a little bit of turbulence.
We go for the runway 32 visual. Right. Activate. Here we see our procedure. It's inside here. I will move it here. Second pipeline. Right. Why it's not showing here? External GPS. So
here we go.
Okay. You can see it on the G2X, the procedure from the 750 is connected with the G2X, and this is where we shoot our approach.
Yeah. I see it from Victor 3, November Mike, I think it was.
Yeah.
Point.
Okay, I will engage the autopilot on heading mode, altitude 3000.
It's the first time I see the castle of Little Bichel here now from the air. We were just discussing yesterday, we were in this town down below us, and I never looked at the castle from above, always just from the street.
It's nice. It's a nice little village.
Yeah. For the US guys, they're thinking, wow, a castle. We only see that in Disneyland.
For the people from Europe, it's worth it to visit this.
We have the same amount of castles as you guys have McDonald's.
That's a lot.
That's a lot. Exactly.
Okay.
How much fuel do we have? 40 liters. We can't make it to
47.
47.
Why?
We can't make it to Croatia right now.
You can zoom out and you can check, maybe in echo mode.
I go to 55.
Wait, I will reduce. This is Denmark, Lukasz.
Oh, sorry.
It's Croatia.
I was looking at the wrong ocean. Hey, but either way, we can make it to Denmark or we can make it to Croatia.
We can make it easily.
Yeah, we can make it to Croatia.
Sounds cool. Well,
we should not tell Jakub and just leave.
Okay,
I'll zoom this back in.
Okay, now I will go to the Victor 3 November Mike point. I need 3,000 feet there. Then we select approach, halt button, and he should fly a 3-degree path for the runway 30 right.
Let's do it.
Here you can see the glide already showing up.
Yep.
It's the same ID behind as an ILS.
Okay.
It's also possible to shoot an ILS with the NAVCO, but we haven't this system at this airport.
I guess we would have to go to Padre Bitte.
Yeah, but then we need to file an IFR flight plan, and this is something we can do in Europe with an ultralight.
Yeah, we'll tell them. Padre Bitte approach. Oscar Kilo Zulian from Hill 04 is now starting our descent for a long final on the runway 30 at Visa Comito. Request frequency change.
Oscar Kilo Zulian from Golf 04. Contact me to radio 130605,
bye. 130605,
dobry večer. Okay. Jakub, 2 minutes and 50 seconds out. Okay, we're now on the glide. He's taking a descent. Full on autopilot.
Good. Oh, this is super easy.
Commito, Oscar Kilo Zulian from Golf 04 is a 5 miles final for the Mid 304 go route after.
It's easy to fly this plane.
Yeah.
Okay, switch on the landing lights. And from that point we will get the purple squares.
It's called the sky, the highway in the sky.
Yeah, and then we have to follow this one.
The hits.
And in this way you can also fly this manual if you don't want to use autopilot.
Yeah, that's cool. Oh, right now it looks like the descent path is a little too steep.
Now I will slow down because I need 81 knots to reduce my gear.
Yeah.
Jakub, we're 1 minute and a half.
Little bumpy here, but nothing too bad. Ooh.
Going to fully fine.
Okay, reducing.
Now you see how fast this plane is.
Yeah. Now we'll have an eternity before we get there.
Gear is coming.
Yes, it's holding the glide slope.
Oh. Three greens, undercarriage, fully fine. Running light on.
Radar, Delta 47.
I'll switch off the monitor.
Okay. Okay, we go to one flap.
And now the only thing you have to do is
500.
Use the power.
Yeah. Oscar Kilo 3 from Golf 04, it's final runway 30 with the go rounds.
Oh, that's cool, I saw the min speed warning come up there, you were right on the edge there. So guys, we're not touching the control stick at all, just playing with the throttle a little bit. Propeller is fully flying, trim is set, and the autopilot is just taking us all the way to the ground. So we're in VFR, we're a couple hundred feet from the runway now, and let's just see how accurate this thing is. This is a non-official approach.
Okay, and now you do the missed approach, going around, full power.
So it took us to maybe 400, 500 feet of the runway and to an altitude of maybe 50, 60 feet. Crazy.
Full power is going up, gear up, flaps up.
Is it still autopilot?
Yes,
still autopilot.
I just helped a little bit to slow down enough for the flap speed, but that's it. Because we're still on autopilot.
Yeah. That's cool. Now can I do this on a regular takeoff?
I'm still on autopilot.
Yeah. Look, both hands up.
Because if we have an auto throttle, we can do an auto landing.
Oh, that'd be cool. Yeah, that's the next generation. So I think we're still a couple years. years away from that.
Okay, I will switch off the autopilot. We'll make a few low approaches for Jakub. He would like to shoot something with the drone.
No problem.
Jakub? I come now for the low approach. I will do first a slow one. Okay, you want us to come from the way we came for the sun, or it's better the other way?
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay. Everything we did now at the plane was full autopilot. Yeah, you don't give a shit, I think.
Say it again.
All the stuff we did now on the runway was full autopilot. With the drone when I do the landing, and you can use this also, eh?
Yes.
And then you can come closer, don't worry, don't worry, you can come close.
I trimmed up on the wrong side. Oh, so now it's more to the left.
And visual commit to Oscar Kilo, Soviet Franco 04, starting phase and final, runway 30 for a low approach.
It's nice in the system.
Yeah, it's super good.
In position. I will fly over the runway so you can come close as you want. I just stay over the concrete, don't worry about me.
Caution, sink rate.
Oh, come on, it's only 1,500 feet.
Caution, sink rate.
I'm idle, I'm too fast.
Yeah.
Ask a kilo zero from Gulf Stream 4. Final 30, low approach.
Doing a nice slow, low approach, low pass here. Only doing about 100 knots.
I'm still idle.
Yeah. Yeah, you see. The guy's building the hangar stopped working and we were looking.
Power. Now we go for the fast one.
Yeah, this thing climbs like crazy.
Visa Comito, Oscar Kilo, Sulian for Gulf 04, joining left hand down and to the right 30 low approach. I will make two low approaches, Jakub. The first one, I go just, I pull up, and that's it. The second one, I will pull up and turn to the left.
Copy.
Where is the best position to pull up, over the runway or at the end of the runway?
At the end of the runway.
Okay.
Alright, check my seatbelt. I'm set. As we will pull a little bit of G's, nothing too crazy, but just gotta be prepared for it.
Runway is clear.
Let's go. Yeah, so it's always, today we don't have any wind, but when we do a low approach, it's always best to do it in the way that landing traffic goes. That way you'll avoid anybody coming the other direction. So now we're managing our RPM settings, managing our speed, dipping down. As we're crossing the runway threshold, wings level. Knots over the ground. It gets me every time.
And it's 1,000 feet.
That was 1,000 feet in like 15 seconds.
Next one is coming up, and now a pull up and a turn to the left. Oscar Kilo, Zulian from Golf 04, joining left hand down and 3-0, low approach.
Sync rate, pull up.
I think this one's going to be a little bit faster.
500.
Oscar Kilo 04, short 3-0. You have enough?
Yeah, we're good. Let's go for the landing.
Okay, go in position. I will try to land at the beginning of the runway on the numbers.
Okay.
You can go in position there. And Oscar Kilo Zulu from Golf 04 is joining left hand down and turning 3-0, full stop.
That was a good pull.
That's only 2G.
Oh, yeah. Alright guys, so we're preparing for landing here. Gear comes down at around 81 knots, not around 81 knots is gear down speed. First knots are flaps around 75 knots.
Three greens, undercarriage fully fine, flaps set, speed checked, fuel pumps on, landing light on.
I hope Jakub gets a good video with the drone shot, so...
I think so.
This is gonna be cool because we're virtually at no wind, almost no wind, and we'll have a really, really short field landing, so it's gonna be a real cool shot from the drone. You'll see how short you can actually land the VL3.
Okay, final approach is free, the runway is clear. Continue approach.
Yeah, well, you're doing a short field, so it's okay. I was gonna say, you flew a real Boeing pattern today.
Okay, three greens. Undercarriage, fully fine. Flaps set, speed checked. Landing light on, fuel pumps up.
Windsock is showing no wind. Oh, that was loud. I thought you were gonna stop it to show like...
I didn't touch any brake. I will brake now a bit.
Oh, it's okay. Yeah, well, we could have stopped in... couple meters there, but all good, no worries. Alright guys, thanks for tuning in. This is Lucas Bestiovsky, and I have Joran Vermeulen next to me. I'm going to beg Jakub to post the entire video, not just make a little snippet out of it. I think you guys would really enjoy this content. The more likes, the more comments you guys make, we'll see what you guys want to watch. So we're open to suggestions. We have VL3s to our disposal, so we can do anything you guys want to see. If you have any questions or stuff you'd like to see us try out, no problem.